This episode of FineScale Modeler's new product rundown features Roden's O2 Skymaster, AMT's Kenworth Cement Mixer, and Agora's T-800.
New product rundown brought to you by Hobby Zone USA, your source for hobby storage solutions, hard-to-find hobby tools, and aftermarket modeling needs.
Happy New Year and welcome to another edition of New Product Rundown, the show where we go through and look at the latest kits. I'm Tim Kidwell.
I'm Aaron Skinner. Our first kit up for this year is Roden's 1/32nd scale Cessna Skymaster.
This boxing represents one of six former U.S. Air Force O2s transferred to the Navy and used as range controllers with VFA 125.
A look at the fuselage halves reveals fine recessed panel lines. The starboard cabin door is separate, as are the nose, rear engine fairing, and the main gear cover. All of the windows are designed to fit from outside, which should help with painting.
In addition to cockpit detail molded inside the fuselage halves, there's also a floor, four seats, racks of avionics and radios, instrument panel, shroud, and controls.
Detailed engines occupy the front and rear compartments and include block halves, separate cylinder heads, plumbing, and other parts. The front cowl panels are separate, but the instructions don't indicate that they can be posed open. The prop blades are also separate and fit into a spinner up front and multi-part hub out back. Landing gear struts mate with detailed front and rear wheels.
The wings build from a full span upper half, lower halves split between the sides and separate tips. Optional actuators allow the flaps to be posed up or down. The booms come in halves with separate rudders. They're connected with a one-piece horizontal stabilizer with separate elevator.
Unused in this kit but included are wing pylons and a selection of pods suited for the Air Force Forward Air Controller version.
The kit decals provide markings for a single VFA 125 Rough Riders O2A in blue, yellow, and white.
This is a good size for the subject, and it looks like Roden has packed in the detail. It'll be interesting to see how it goes together.
Next, let's take a look at AMT's 1/25th scale Kenworth-Challenge cement mixer.
This unique version of the W900 does not appear to have been issued since 1971. The cab is mostly a single part with raised and recessed details, as well as windshield wipers. The hood is also a single part with the fenders included.
That hood is movable to reveal a detailed engine with a block, pulleys, and belts, transmission, manifolds, and other equipment.
The frame rails join with two-part cross members. The rear suspension bogies and drive axles, as well as the front springs and axle, connect to wheels, the rear ones are chrome-plated, that get wrapped with Firestone-branded vinyl tires. Other details on the frames include chrome-plated fuel and water tanks, front bumper, and the battery box.
To detail the cab interior tub, the kit provides a firewall, passenger and driver seats, dashboard, shifters, pedals, and steering wheel. Each cab window is separate. The clear tree also supplies headlight lenses.
Other cab details include the radiator and its chrome grille, chrome exhaust stacks, mirrors, horns, air cleaner, and cab lights. Yellow and red clear plastic supplies cab, turn signal, and taillight lenses.
To support the two-part mixing barrel, there's a frame and front and rear brackets. There are also separate fenders, a chain drive, mixer blades, and a hopper and movable chute.
The decals supply markings, stripes, and checks for the barrel, titles and stripes for the cab, black and white numbers, and license plates.
This is a neat kit, and it should be welcomed by fans of commercial and construction subjects.
Finally, here's an exciting kit from Agora Models, a 1/2 scale T-800 endoskeleton from the Terminator.
This kit is a subscription available in 12 monthly packs.
Each box includes multiple blister packs for each stage in the clearly laid out instructions. Each book has extra stories about the movies or related information.
The parts are a combination of plated plastic and cast metal for a realistic finish without painting.
I built the head, including lighting and motors for the eyes and jaw, in about 2 hours. Most of the parts join with small screws, but you'll also need super glue to add small parts like teeth.
In the end, you'll have a 3-foot-tall model of the chilling cyborg that can be posed and whose eyes and jaw can be made to move. The base has lights and sound effects, including the theme from the original movie.
Obviously, this is a kit that will require a substantial commitment of time and money, but the reward will be a showcase in your living room, den, or office.
Maybe you can put it in the corner of your bedroom as a nightlight.
Sure.
Nightmares.
Anyway, look for reviews of the O2 and the Kenworth on FineScale.com.
And you can find more reviews and new products in the pages of the February issue on sale now.
Thanks for visiting FineScale.com. I'm Tim Kidwell.
I'm Aaron Skinner, and here's to a good 2021.
Happy New Year, and welcome to...
You forgot what you work for?
I've been off of school. Off of school. I don't even know where I'm at anymore. God. Now, it is a new decade. Yes, it is. It is a new decade. Ha-ha! Do it again.
Yes, I know. I'm trying to get back into my my happy place.
Nightmares.